Okay, so you lost your way. Your keto fasting lifestyle that you had in a groove has completely gone away and you don't know where to begin. Join me on this video, 7 steps you can take to get yourself back on track. And I put a little bonus at the end on how you deal with carb and sugar and alcohol cravings. So as always, join me and I hope this one helps. So you fell off your keto and fasting wagon, you're beating yourself up, and you don't know what to do and where to hop back on. What I want to do is in this video, I want to show you 7 things that you can start to implement immediately and mindset tools you can use so that you don't end up down what I call the rabbit hole of poor health too deep, that we can actually pull you out from there and we can give you some strategies so you can hop right back on to a healthy keto and fasting lifestyle. So sit tight, I got 7 things for you. And at the end, I'm gonna give you a bonus idea that I use with my patients around cravings, things like carbohydrate and sugar cravings. How the heck are you gonna beat those things? How are you gonna overcome some of those things that tend to derail us in the keto and fasting world? So, okay, so let's start with this. My first thing. Don't beat yourself up. It's not gonna do you any good. Wherever you are right now, if you went and you were like so great at keto and then all of a sudden out of the blue, you just went on a binge and you are so mad at yourself for doing that. My first piece of advice, don't beat yourself up. It's not gonna do you any good. Wake up tomorrow, start the new day, implement the things I'm gonna share with you. But don't keep carrying the pain and the suffering on into those, to the day after day after day until all of a sudden 3 or 4 months have gone by, you've been beating yourself up and you're down a bigger rabbit hole. So there was, just to give you some hope, there are some really interesting studies that have shown that the longer you try to create a new habit and fail, and then try to create a new habit and fail, that eventually you're gonna succeed. Like they've shown with smoking that if somebody tries like 3 or 4 times and to stop smoking and then they are and they fail at it, if they each time they try, they become a little more successful and a little more successful. I actually found an article that showed it takes about 30 attempts to stop smoking in order for somebody to be successful. So if you know you're an overeater, if you know that you have a big sugar cravings, like just, you know what, look yourself in the mirror and say, yep, I messed up and now I'm gonna hop right back on. Like done, draw a line in the sand, hopping right back on. We also know there's studies that have shown that people doing something as simple as the every other day diet, where they took people with horrible diets and they found that if they let them eat whatever they wanted on one day, and then the next day they fasted, and then the next day they could eat whatever they wanted. They did that for a year, and over a year's time, they found that their cravings changed, they lost weight, their blood work improved, only from just every other day fasting, but then on those off days, they ate junk in the beginning. So know that your body wants to reset itself, so no beating yourself up, okay? That's the first thing. Okay, second thing. Wherever you are right now, figure out what is the right fast for you. What's the right style of eating right now? Okay, it doesn't mean, maybe you did a 5-day water fast a month ago. Maybe you were like a keto queen 2 months ago. Doesn't mean that that's the right place for you to be right now. The human body is always changing. Our stress loads are changing. So you got to figure out what's the perfect scenario for you. This is where diet variation comes in. So my basic variation that I really emphasize to a lot of people is called a 5-1-1, where 5 days a week you're doing a keto lifestyle with 13 to 15 hours of fasting. 1 day a week you're doing keto with a 24-hour fast, and 1 day a week you're feasting and you're not fasting. It's a really doable variation. So if you haven't implemented that, like especially I'm doing this video right before the holidays, you know, it's especially if you're about to enter into the holidays, this can be a really good variation for you, 5-1-1. But figure out, maybe I've done this with patients before where we'll sit down and we'll go, okay, and they'll tell me like, my life is so crazy and hectic right now. And I'll say, okay, how about you stay off of gluten and you do 15 hours of fasting every day. And that's all you're gonna do. So set yourself up for success. Don't do, just because you could knock it out of the park with fasting a month ago doesn't mean that today that's right for you. So figure out what the variation is, figure out what your parameters are, and commit to doing that. And it doesn't, again, it's not always the same. Okay, third thing, go tell an accountability partner or go announce it to a community what you're gonna do. This is why I love the Resetter group, because I see this all the time where people will post in that group and they will say, hey, I fell off the wagon. I'm hopping back on, doing a 3-day water fast. Who's joining me? In that community right now on Facebook, we've got like 25,000 people there. Here on YouTube, we have over 100,000 people. We've got a community page here. So if you are going to start a fast or you're going to start a new habit, you can announce it to us. We got a team of people that will rally around you and cheer you on and support you. You can join us in the Resetters. Just put Resetter in the group or in your comments and we'll invite you in over there. Or you could tell somebody who's like an amazing accountability partner, somebody that you know is not going to let you off the hook, and you could just announce to them, this is what I'm doing, hold me accountable. But you need to verbalize it, either written or verbally tell somebody, and have a community or a person there supporting you. Okay, so that's my third thing. Okay, fourth, I love measurement. So pull out your Keto Mojo, pull out your blood sugar reader. If you haven't pulled it out in a while, pull it out and start looking at your blood sugar and your ketones. You may be surprised. So you might be shocked at how high your blood sugar is because you've been not following the keto and fasting lifestyle for a while and your blood sugar may be higher than you want it to be. Well then, if it is, use the next week to and next couple days of your fasting or your diet variation or whatever food agreement you've made with yourself, and use that as a measurement to see it go, that number go down. Same thing with ketones. Are you able to go, if you fast 15 hours, are you getting into ketosis? If you're not, then make that the goal. Don't make the number on the scale the goal, because there's too many variables. The number on the scale can be an accumulation of how much water you're holding on to, or your detox pathways open. There's too many variables, so don't put your mindset locked into the number on the scale. The glucose reader, the ketone reader, really makes a difference. And if you don't have one, just put Keto Mojo in the comments and we'll send you, get you a link for those. But start making make the blood sugar and ketone your measurement. Okay, sixth thing. Now, let's say it depends on when you're watching this, what time of the year you're in, but I always like to have something out in front of me that I know, like a program, or this is why I create resets that are like out in front of me that I'm going to know that I'm gonna click into. So we've got women's resets we're running all the time. So if you want information on our women's reset, put that in there. We have a Forever Young reset I'm launching in January 2020. I've got a live event. So we have things in January for you to step into. If you need a program, if you need a community, make sure you're engaging in one of those. But maybe for some of you, it's that you've been watching the CrossFit gym down the street from you and you've been thinking, maybe I should join that. Well, if you fell off the bandwagon, you're hopping back on, initiating in some kind of program where it's exercise, where it's a diet program, something where you have structure will really make a difference. So, and that will kind of stop what I call the bleeding, stops you from continuing the poor habits. And again, you're tapping into a community. And then the seventh thing before I go into the bonuses on cravings and things like that is the seventh thing is make sure you celebrate the small wins. So let's say you've been doing keto really well for months, you dropped a ton of weight, then you boomeranged back, you gained the weight back, and you're starting over again. So if that's you, then your first step is to see some ketones on that Keto Mojo reader. And if you're seeing ketones on there, awesome. You got to celebrate that. Like, pat yourself on the back. You did great. Be proud of that. Just because it might not be where you were 2 months prior doesn't mean that it's not great. So celebrate that you got into ketosis and that you're back having momentum in a forward direction. The other thing I like to do is reward major wins. So if you have a weight loss goal in mind, maybe your goal for the month of December is that you just want to follow a 5-1-1 variation, or you want to intermittent fast all the time. Maybe that's just your goal. Well, then if you hit that goal, reward yourself. And I don't mean reward yourself with a big piece of chocolate cake. I mean reward yourself with like a new shirt or a new some jewelry, or maybe something that you've wanted and it seems frivolous and you're not going to really buy it. Put it out there as your reward. Go get a massage. It doesn't have a facial, a pedicure. It does not have to be a big thing, but you want to set up, I'm going to do this for X amount of weeks, and when I do it, I'm going to, and complete it successfully, I'm going to reward myself. And sometimes those rewards will pull you forward, and it's a great opportunity. Again, when you hit it, awesome opportunity to just acknowledge the hard work that you're putting in, because with fasting, nobody can do it but you. You're the only one that can do it. So make sure you really take the time to acknowledge that. Okay, let me finish up with this. Let's talk about cravings, and I probably could do a whole video on this. If you know you have intense carb or sugar cravings, and you've had them for a long time, there are a couple of thoughts I have for you. One is get your gut tested. Find out if you've got candida inside your microbiome of your gut. Candida is a fungus that is going to make you crave alcohol, carbohydrates, and sugar. The other thing is make sure you're eating enough good fat. So good fat will help stabilize your blood sugar, so you're not doing this up and down that might make you crave sugar. And then the last thing, one of my favorite, do I have it in here? I wanted to bring it to you guys. Okay, this is a really cool supplement, and it's called sinulin, and it helps to stabilize blood sugar. So sometimes just getting people to balance their blood sugar will take those cravings away. So test your gut. Improve your good fat, try supplements like sinulin, and see if that helps with the cravings. And once those cravings go, now remember, 24 hours, intestinal stem cells are gonna kick in. So they're gonna help with some of the gut bacteria in there that might be encouraging those cravings. So, okay, but promise me, whatever you do, you don't give up on yourself. Just because you lost some momentum doesn't mean that has to be your future. You can always reset your health. Okay? As always, I hope that helps.